We've got stagflation, no economy, no jobs, and a 91% chance of this happening in the market. But more important than that was my background. I screwed up. Like, what are you guys doing here? And I don't know if you guys caught this. This over here is the CEO of AMC talking to my guy over here. And right about now, he's going to move his camera and show the world that he does not wear pants. And my guy doesn't even flinch. I'm like, bro, the CEO just flashed his man parts at you and you just... Which actually, since 2000, right? That doesn't even seem... That seems normal. I mean, just for him wearing pants would have been like, why is he wearing pants? And first things first, in the stock market, and I think you guys are pretty smart, but maybe I can add something to your smartness. Did you know less is more? Well, I mean, that's what I tell my wife. And I don't know. Maybe I'm lying to her. I don't know. Look for smaller gains. Babe, just smile. Just look for smaller gains. In second year of U.S. stocks bull market, I wanted to show you guys this. So stocks, right? Bull market. Do you know we just actually entered a brand new bull market? People are like, no, we've been in a bull market since forever. No, we actually just entered it. But the truth is, since 1957, 62, 66, 70, 74, 82, except for 87, you gotcha, 90, 02, 09, and now, let me move. You see that? You're gonna have to work a little bit harder this time. But praise be, blessed be the fruit, and you gotta grab that fruit as fast as you can. This is the way. Look at this. Upset. Oh, you can't see it. Thought something was wrong with my screen. S&P up almost 1%. The NASDAQ up almost 2%. Now, mind you, this is on bad economic data. This is, which I am going to get into all of that said, bad economic end of the world data. But if you have your currency sitting in the bank doing absolutely nothing, I would like to punch myself in the face. No, Bravo, I will just own gold. Okay, great. That's step one. Gold is money, protects your wealth, stays the same. Good. Now I need to preface, this is not financial advice. I don't know. What do I know? I am just said YouTuber. And said YouTuber does not care what you trade. I like Bitcoin because it is so volatile, but very difficult to trade. Unless you have some knowledge, which in about T-minus 30 hours, this thing's gonna break. So stay glued to that TV set, kids, because Santa Claus is coming to town. He's coming to town with a 30% bag of goodies to the upside or to the downside. Also, Bravo Claus, Christmas comes early with almost 70% off. Link in the description if you want to know how to help your accounts. I will handhold you. I will walk you through every step of the way. Yesterday, I left you with a cliffhanger. I apologize because I had mentioned McDonald's. I'm like, I don't want to go into this. I don't have time. And now you're like, wait, I hold McDonald's. Look, when a stock goes up, look at this. See this? It's going up that way. You're like, yes. But you have what's called a negative divergence on the MACD. That is a no. So if McDonald's sells off and touches the 50, which it looks like it's been bouncing off of, but then wants to go down to the 200, but you know this because you're in the course, you understand these things. I just don't want your happy meal to come as a surprise. And in regards to McDonald's, this is actually a future story. I'm pushing towards the end. We got to get these like stonks in and then we hit Mickey D's. You guys are making almost $20 an hour. They're having to increase higher wages, signing bonuses, help fuel restaurant job rebound. Back in the day, I used to make $3.35 an hour fast food, and now it's 20, okay? So just make sure you hold that currency in that account. Just keep it in there. And I, you know what? I need to apologize that you guys actually have to move your money constantly, but that is the only way. But I pinky promise, once you learn these basics, like you get, I'd say my course gives you 80%. You are good And not only are you good, you get to go hang out with people and talk about things. And people are like, well, did you hear this? And, you know, Trump and Biden and all this kind of stuff. And you're like, ah. Goldman Prime, massive short covering leads to biggest hedge fund rout since March. Is there money to be made? I say, yes, there is. You have to know when to get in, when to get out. Other than that, I mean, if you're just following the news where I get those phone calls or those texts, like, workhorse, you talked about workhorse. Like, yeah, okay. You see? And when it comes to like shorts, they have to cover it. Oh, let's short it. Yay, that'll work. Well, now you got to buy it back. What happens then? Short squeeze, stock goes up. But that doesn't mean you just hodl. No, you got to take profits off. Unless you're a GameStop warrior, then you hodl to the end. I get it. You just pass your hodl on to your kids. Cowen downgrades workhorse calls. Latest move, mean stock spike, and it is currently down 15%. But that's okay, because you already closed your position. You're fine. Now, on to everything bass ackwards, right? Oh, please tell us, Chris, outlook on the Fed's role and all this. Stock market, live news updates, stocks rise as you want to know why stocks rose? I'll tell you. Because it was bad news. Now, everyone's like, this is so confusing. I thought if it's good news, no, not since 2008. Stocks rise as investors eye mixed May jobs report. And Emily McCormick, I will explain to you, young lady, what the frack is going on. And even though if I were to scroll here, May jobs report, economy adds back 559,000 jobs. Unemployment rate fell to negative, right? What is it, 5% now? Are we going to be at negative 5%? And everyone's like, but I'm broke. Aha, yes, you are broke. But the people that do this, see that Wall Street over there? Yes, those people are not said broke. And I actually have to laugh at some of these articles, these economists. How do you even do it? Economists brace for another volatile monthly U.S. jobs report. Volatile. Am I going to say it volatile or volatile or what kind of tile is it? Now, check this out. Well, we're estimating from the range of somewhere between 300,000 and a million, somewhere in between there. And I say, let's look at the numbers and see what is going on. Oh, leisure and hospitality. We gained almost 200,000 waiters and bartenders. That means we have a healthy economy. Everything is great. Oh, wait. Let's not forget education. We also hired more government. Oh, wait. That would also be government. We also hired more government. So government is up, education is up, and the waiters and bartenders are up. But it's also up so much that it really wasn't. It even missed their mark, and the stock market rallies higher. You want to know what didn't go up? That would be things that would be in an economy, like construction, trade, lodging, temp and help. Temp. Oh, see, temp. Temp's up here. Great. Temporary workers. We got it. But manufacturing, no. I mean, that's kind of a break even on that one. Basically, what happened last month. So thank goodness that we added all of this stuff and stimmies. That does not help an economy. And it's crazy how governments will tout, look, we have higher wages. Well, that's because you got to beat the $20 an hour you're paying them to sit at home on the couch. Signing bonuses help fuel restaurant job rebound. Yay. And I'll tell you what else will happen. Let's see if we can just do the general math on this one. Eateries compete for labor by paying more and loosening rules and raising the price on you. Have you seen that? You go out to eat and they're like, oh, it's a service, these random service fees just because we can. And last but not least, coming in from stagflation. Peter Schiff has been preaching that. That's what you guys say in the comments section. You're like, have you been keeping up with Peter? I'm like, no, a little bit. But I guess stagflation is here. Look at this. U.S. manufacturers' new order cratered. That's great. Just when you thought it is a healthy economy. No, you need to make stuff. Produce. That's what an economy is. You make things, okay? And here's a shameless plug. is if you've already gone through my stock market course and you're like, maybe I should make something. Oh, and what's Kristen buying? This is the part of the show where it's, what is Jay Bravo's wife currently? And I manufactured this one. Oh my gosh, why is she buying it? And I swear on Jim Cramer's head that that was one of my products that years back. I used to make silicone kind of baking mats. But to be fair to my wife, we sold everything. There is like we sold everything in California. We came with carry-on. But if for some reason you decide, I want to manufacture something, I want to make one thing, well, link in the description. I will walk you through it. I think that course is cheaper than my Stonks course. Bigger discount on that one. And you want to know how much this guy makes an aluminum tray? He makes, I'm not even kidding you. See right above my head? An aluminum tray. Not a difficult one, right? And it's not cool when you're at the bar and they're like, so what do you do? I make aluminum trays. $564,000 every 30 days. Or you could be like these guys, right? One, two, she's probably works there, three. These people are giving up their time. Most valuable thing you will ever have in your entire life is your time to serve tables. And then they're like, well, we'll pay you a dollar more. Well, don't you want to be on the other side where you're actually the person paying the people so you can go do the things that you want to do in your life? And I'm not saying own like these guys, you know, own a restaurant. I'm not saying that. No, a little bit smarter. Be the one who actually provides to the restaurant. I actually learned this lesson a long time ago. I used to own a day spa and I had 30, 40 people working for me, running around. And it was the people that I would order from. I'm like, you make good money. And I'm sitting here having to work 24 hours a day. I think I messed up. And it's just the way of looking at things. But you know what? I would love to be a bartender. It's fun. Okay, that's great. But you have like that passive income stuff on the side that's like, if I want to do it, I can do it or not. I mean, Amazon definitely producing a product will help you get there. And also, just for you, because you made it to the very end, I'll throw something, a new link on if you want both of them, like how to start businesses and trade. Link in the description, both of them, some killer package. I don't know. I'll just like randomly hit a couple buttons and it's all yours. And I will see you tomorrow.